the ripe old age of 4, our next guest knew he had a gift, and he has been wowing audiences ever since. Please welcome Jalon Watts.
Red hot sun road behind her, 1 mile in her hometown. Drops a quarter in the beat of payphone. You can see it rattle on down. Hold as cold as the phone she's holding. The connection's way too clear. He's the NOS, my dealer. She's too far gone to care. She says, listen. There's a time to stay. Part the distance of his own. Starts talking to the bottle. He's left now that she's gone. Bridges on to the national anthem. Comes on his TV. Then he looks straight at the bottle. Says, you did this to me. And then he screams. There's a time to stand. And the time is now or never. Time to fly.
Been genetically engineered with supersized lungs because, wow, how do you get enough breath in there? That's amazing. All right. So at the ripe old age of 4, you entered a talent competition in Santaquin. And is that when you knew you had something pretty special?
Well, my grandma got me into this talent competition, and I sang Grand Ole Flag and Yankee Doodle Dandy, which I held a little flag out there waving it.
And, oh, well, that did it.
I couldn't even say my R's, but it was so fun. I mean, it was just so fun, and I just loved it ever since. So we've been doing those local things. And
there you have it. And so since then, you've been doing competitions. You've been getting standing ovations. You've got a song over on the European charts called Dear Mr. Jesus.
Peaked at number 10, debuted at number 20. It was cool. It was fun.
Okay, so Martina McBride, she's kind of your...
Yeah. Well, she is definitely my favorite singer.
Why?
Well, my grandma kind of introduced me to her through, we were up the canyon one day, and she started playing this greatest hit CD. I was like, whoa, who is this? And I was listening to all the songs. She's like, oh, this is my favorite. And so I was just really excited about her music, and I've just loved her ever since.
Well, I think you're in good company. She is amazing. All right, and then Senator Hatch. Are you actually working with him on a song?
Yeah, we went and met up with him in Salt Lake, and he introduced us to a song called Come Home. It's about a soldier coming home. They want him to come home, and so we're going to put that on a CD.
Nice.
So we're going to try to work on that, yeah.
All right, Jalon, you were obviously raised right because you brought my dear colleagues a little gift. Do you want to grab that while they come on? What did you bring? Is it over here?
Okay, here. I can tell you. We'll stand here and patiently wait.
Okay, you know what? I'm impressed with his voice.
Yes.
But I'm so impressed with...
Candy's on Main in Manti, Utah.
Oh, thank you.
Your presence is so unbelievable.
We met these people... the Kirkham family at a farm fest, another little gig that we did in the summer last year, and they've just been on board ever since, and they're so awesome, so yeah.
I want to hear you on the Grand Ole Opry, and you have a gift.
Yeah. I know. I want you to sign an album for me when you get that out there. You're amazing.
Jalon, tell everybody where they can find more information on you, your music, and everything you're up to.
JalonWatts.com. That pretty much has everything that we're still trying to get it up there, but it's up and it's ready, so JalonWatts.com would be the best place
okay,
to go.
Okay, Jalon, you can work that microphone. I love how you pass it back and forth.
That's what I'm saying. That guy's got it.
We'll link that on our website as well at abc4.com, JalonWatts.com.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks for the candy, too.
We'll be right back.